So where are all the students?
They're outside in the living lab. To be a biologist involves interacting with life and living organisms in the real world. The University of Plymouth's location in the living lab of the Southwest makes it an excellent location to study biology in all its forms, both on land and in the sea.
So as part of being a marine biology student at the University of Plymouth, I had the opportunity to join one of the marine mammal surveys on board the university sailing yacht, where we go along the south coast looking for whales, dolphins, porpoises, other marine mammals in particular, but also things like sharks and large fish, such as sunfish or tuna. Our objective is to find out more about the marine mammals that are using the south coast, hopefully provide some insight about how important this place is for marine mammals and therefore afford them some protection that they need to be conserved properly.
The University of Plymouth is a premium destination to study marine biology because of our close proximity to the ocean, the expertise of the staff who work here, and our excellent facilities. The interdisciplinary approach that students learn at the University of Plymouth emphasizes the way that the ecosystem must be examined as a whole in order to understand how climate change is going to affect all of us.
Today I am collecting some data for my research project, looking at whether sheep and livestock increase soil compaction. So I'm collecting soil penetrometer data across the field on a broad scale and an experimental scale. The objective of the study is to understand the ecological impacts that livestock have on soil compaction and flooding.
Our students study not only natural biological systems, but also productive systems. That is, the production of food in both terrestrial and marine habitats. Understanding how productive systems are going to respond to climate change is amazingly important if we're going to be able to feed a growing population of humans and see how our productive systems will actually respond to climate change.
Today we're out on the water in Plymouth Sound, aiming to look at the fish assemblages that live within the seagrass beds. Our seagrass beds here in the UK are really important habitats for fish species, but unfortunately seagrass beds in the UK are, and across a lot of the globe, are declining and they're not very well protected here in the UK. So what we're aiming to do is quantify the value that these seagrass beds provide to our fisheries. So we're deploying some baited remote underwater videos to capture some visual footage of the fish, and we're also collecting some acoustic data and water samples to analyse the DNA and see if we can identify fish in the water in the seagrass beds.
Understanding the importance of biology as we move into the future is critical if we need to maintain our environment in the face of climate change, feed our world, and maintain a balance with the natural ecosystems that we are all a part of and live in.
I study marine science because I want to provide the research that informs marine conservation efforts here in the UK.
I study zoology because I want to understand how animals adapt to a changing world.
I study marine biology because in order to protect our blue planet, we need to understand it and get people engaged with the life that we have in our oceans.